SpectacuLAB or something. I'm not really sure. I don't really get paid for this, so I don't know. I'm an intern, you know. Yeah, hi, how's it going? Can you sit right over here, right up front if you want? Yeah, join us right here. Perfect. Awesome. Well, welcome, everyone. I was just about to do, well, I'm not exactly sure. What was I supposed to do here? All right, I've got a list. Welcome, everyone. Welcome. Everyone? All right, perfect. Okay, got that over with. Introduce myself. Right, yes. I'm Francis, the intern, first day. But please, call me Frankie.
Hi, Frankie.
Okay, yes, hi. Hello,
Frankie.
Perfect. All right, let's see here. Connect auxiliary cable to sound output node. That sounds fun. All right. All right, let's see here. Let's see what this does here. Whoa! Gotta crank it all the way up to feel the vibes. Who's freaking? Go freaking. Oh yeah. It's my birthday. This is awesome, you guys. I love this music. Oh, right. Yes. That's my alarm. Alright, let's see here. Oh, it's time. Alright, let's do this. Oh, 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 this is exciting, you guys.
Try this out now that I know a little bit more about it.
pressure in the sensors on these cars, and that makes sure that you don't run into anything. And I was using that same science to make music, all through ultrasonic pressure. Under pressure, pushing down on me, pushing down on me.
That's not the only kind of pressure either. There's pressure all around us.
Yeah, tell me about it. Today's my first day, I've got exams, I've got laundry to do.
And that's not the pressure I'm talking about either. Like, do you know what this room is filled with?
Air?
Yes, exactly, Frankie, air. Air is all around us, pushing on us, exerting pressure. Pressure is how hard something pushes over a certain amount of area. We call the pushing done by air barometric pressure. Normally, we don't think about the air pushing on us, but we can feel its effects more often than we realize.
Right, like if you've been up in an airplane and your ears pop. As the airplane gets higher, there's less air above you pushing on you, exerting pressure. As our bodies adjust this change in barometric pressure, the air inside of our ears pushes out, causing them to pop.
So that's why my ears always get plugged up when I'm up in an airplane, because of barometric pressure?
Exactly.
But why don't we show you by doing an experiment?
That sounds fun, but how?
We have a barometric sensor, which is full of tiny silicone sensors that all work together to read the change in barometric pressure. We've attached it to a pulley. Now, we can see a readout of the change in barometric pressure in real time.
Frankie, as our intern, we need your help.
Oh, awesome! What do you need me to do?
Just pull on that rope. Science and technology will do the rest.
Just pull on this rope?
Yes, just pull on the rope. The barometric pressure sensor is detecting how much the air is pushing on it.
Right. As the sensor rises, there's less air exerting pressure on it. Like you when you go up in an airplane.
And we can see this on the screens behind us. The graph shows the change in barometric pressure. As the sensor is lower, we see the graph go up. Inversely, as the sensor gets higher, we see the graph go down.
Wow, that is amazing! Who knew all that science was used to figure this stuff out? How'd I do, boss?
Good, but you're not done yet here.
Whoa, it's so squishy! Oh, and it glows! Meat?
Like our sensor on a string, this cube detects barometric pressure. Even better, this cube changes color as the pressure changes.
And we've created a little game to play.
What games? I love games. Who knew there were games in science?
Hey, can I help? We love games too. Frankie, we need 4 volunteers from the audience.
All right, I'll do that. Awesome. I'm going to need some help. If you guys want to help me out today, I'm going to come right down this ramp right over here. And raise your hand for me. That would be fantastic. How about you guys right here? And how about you two as well? Come on up and join us. Fantastic, right this way. Right up the ramp, right this way. Yes, thank you. Hey, what's your name? Sarah. Nice to meet you, Sarah. You can head on right over to Nacho. What's your name? Audrey. Nice to meet you as well, Audrey. What's your name? Natalie. Nice to meet you, Natalie. Hang out right here. And what's your name? Gabby. Nice to meet you, Gabby. Give it up for our volunteers!
The game is called Scientist Says. I'll show you how the cubes work. So right now, we are reading the change in barometric pressure. They might not be the same color, but that's because the air all around us is moving. And barometric pressure can be affected very easily. It's very sensitive. So whether it's temperature, your location on the stage, weather, even just moving around can change our barometric pressure. But I'll tell you the colors. So, on the ground where the barometric pressure is the highest, it could be yellow. And then when we raise it up, it should be blue, then maybe green, and all the way to the top where the barometric pressure is the lowest, red.
So now that Nasha's described how the cubes work, I'm going to go over how the game works. The screen behind us is going to show a color, and the goal of the game is to match the color of your cube to the color on the screen. Remember, you can change the color of your cube by either raising it or lowering it.
Alright, this is where I come in. I'm going to be playing a scientist, so I'm going to be shouting out colors. Now you guys are going to hold on your cubes from the sides, and you're going to lift your color in your cube up to match the color. So let's try with yellow. So everybody start at the bottom, match the yellow. Alright, and now let's bring it up to blue. Alright, we got blue right here, and how about green? Yes, awesome. Perfect, and how about nicely done. Now everyone bring it back to yellow right down at the bottom. Now audience, when they get 4 in a row, you guys are going to cheer them on, alright? Let's hear it. be so much fun.
We did.
Oh, yeah, right.
We can do a lot of really fun things exploring how pressure works. Remember we said that pressure is the amount that something pushes over a certain area? We call this amount of pushing force.
Oh, I know what the force is. Where's my lightsaber? Let's see here. Oh.
Frankie, not that type of force. When we talk about force, we mean the kind of force that's involved in things like kicking a soccer ball. Your foot exerts force on the ball, causing it to move. Let's show you. We're going to need another volunteer.
Awesome, I can do that. I'm getting good at this. I'm going to need one more volunteer. Let's see here. How about you right there? Yeah, come on over. Awesome. Thank you so much for joining us. Awesome, thank you so much. What's your name? What, Charlie? Nice to meet you, Charlie. Awesome, you're going to hang out right here. Everybody say hi.
By finding how fast it is accelerating.
And we measure this acceleration with another really cool sensor called an accelerometer.
Oh, right, because it measures acceleration.
That's right. I'm going to put this on your right leg, okay? I'm going to just wrap it around your right leg, okay? Alrighty, so this accelerometer works by measuring the change in speed over time, like a race car when you step on the gas.
Oh, yeah.
So, Charlie, what do you think would happen if you were to step on this single paper cup?
I don't know.
Any guesses?
Just wait. It'll crush.
It'll crush. Okay, Charlie thinks it'll crush. Let's put his hypothesis to the test.
Okay, so we just want you to step on it with your right leg.
Right this way.
someone were to lay on a bed of nails.
All right.
They would die.
Think about it.
Okay, let me think about this. The force of the body would be spread out over 1,000 super sharp, scary nails. We learned that the force of someone standing on 100 cuffs is kind of like the same thing, which means they won't get stabbed.
Correct.
Wow. Take this balloon, for example. This balloon can easily be popped by one nail. But we can push it down onto a bed of nails. Because the balloon will be so spread out, each nail isn't pushing that hard.
So how many weights do you think we can get on here?
Oh gosh. How many weights do you guys think we can put on this balloon?
20.
20. I don't think we have 20. All right, here we go.
These two weights together weigh about 5 pounds.
Wow, okay. How about two more and then we'll probably call it quits after that one.
10 pounds.
Wow, okay. Awesome. Drum roll for the final.
Can we go to 15? See?
Wow. Give it up for that balloon, everyone. That was amazing. I guess somebody would be totally fine if they were to lay on a bed of nails.
Let's see here. Let's put this up here, set this up. Oh gosh, okay.
So Frankie, as our intern, I would love to see you be our volunteer.
What? No.
But it's unfortunately prevented by our contract.
Oh, thank goodness.
So then I'll do my partner in crime here, Nausha.
Okay, I like
what? Nausha, you're really gonna do this?
Let's
help you down here. Let's get you set up here. Be very careful, okay? This looks really dangerous. Alright, we're just gonna lay you down here. Alright, let's see here. Wonderful. Okay. Hey kids, do not try this at home. This is not a good idea, alright? Let's see here. Hey, Nausha, are you okay? Is it comfortable? Of course it's not comfortable. It's a bed of nails.
Hey, relax and trust the science.
I do trust the science. It's the human error that I'm worried about.
Frankie, can you give me a hand with this, please?
What? Yes, I will. Here we go. Nausha, we're just going to put more nails on you, since this makes sense. We're going to tuck you in here just for a quick little nap. No big deal. Wow, okay, scary.
There it is.
All right, good, Nausha. All right, hey, I just want to let you know I had a great time working with you this morning, in case you don't make it, you know. Hey, is that absolutely necessary?
Absolutely.
Okay, she just put a cinder block on top of you, Nausha. I'm not sure what Montana's trying to do here.
Frankie, everything's gonna be fine. We need safety goggles.
Right. Safety goggles. Okay, that'll work. Yeah, I'm gonna need some different ones over here. My glasses are too small. Let's get this here.
And remember, kids, do not try this at home or without science supervision.
Oh, gosh.
Amazing!
I can feel it!
down was spread out over 1,000 nails. With the force being so spread out, the pressure of any single nail on my body was low.
Right, just like the 100 cups the extra people on them, you were fine, even with the added force of the sledgehammer and the cinder block. Let's take a look at our accelerometer readout.
Time? Time for what?
It is our honor to bestow upon you, Frankie the intern, your very own science logo!
Oh! This is awesome! Thank you guys so much!
Thank you, Frankie. May it remind you of your role in discovery, invention, and all things science and the importance of science.
Wow, this is so cool, you guys. Thank you guys so much. I will wear it with pride.
Thank you. I hope you and everyone in the audience has a newfound appreciation for science.
Without science, we would miss out on so many wonderful things. Things like cars, mobile phones, healthcare and medical equipment, ultrasonic drums,
yes.
And so much more.
My head is swimming with questions, but I have an internship to ask them. Do you guys have any questions for our scientists? Before we get started, I actually do have one question. How did you guys become scientists?
Well, when I was a kid, I remember reading about the origins of life on Earth and that cells are made by other cells, and I was fascinated by the question, where did the first cells come from, and that made me interested in science. I studied as much science as I could in high school, and then I ended up going through grad school, and now I work in a lab.
Well, when I was a kid, my family took me to aquariums, and dolphins became my favorite animal. And then when I got older in middle school, I learned that there were more things in the ocean than just dolphins. So I wanted to work with them in my future. So when I went to college, I got the chance to research the entire ecosystem, you know, the plants and animals that live in our oceans and in our freshwater sources.
That is so fascinating. Thank you guys so much for being here today. Hey, do you guys have any questions for our scientists? Come on, don't be shy. They obviously know their science stuff. Anyone at all?
How are you not dead?
How did you not get hurt from that?
Yeah, well, remember the force. Pushing down was spread out, so each nail was helping hold me up, so I didn't get hurt.
She was saved by the power of science.
Yes, perfect. I love it. Any more questions? We can take some from back there if you guys want. Yeah? No? Well, thank you guys so much for stopping by the SpectacuLAB presented by Murata today. Keep asking questions and performing your own experiments, keeping safety in mind. Thank you guys so much.